So the required setting is already now. If you observe that, is there any now it is started. Simply I just simply press one button. I don't know whether it is recording or not. Okay. Now from beginning of the class, whether it is recorded or not, I don't know. I hope we lost the first 15 parts. Maybe we lost for 15 first 15 part because I don't know who changed the settings, or I don't know. As far as my knowledge is concerned, whenever the Zoom is open, it automatically recorded. It automatically recorded, but I don't know. Okay. If at all, if there is any problem, I will inquire those things, and maybe from the next class, I try to overcome those difficulties. Right now, I didn't come across of all those things till now. Anyway, no problem. Right. Okay. Thank you. Fine. So very thanks, Amma. Thanks for your concern. Thank you very much. Right. So here the bending moment will be positive if it increases the curvature. That means whenever you find that the curvature is increasing curvature, you will consider that it is a positive bending moment. And if it decreases the curvature, you can consider it is a negative. And the distance y is positive if it is measured from the central axis toward the convex side of, because you observe that in case of a bending stress, especially bending stress. Right. You please observe that. In case of your bending stress, already mentioned in the beginning of the class, we are having a convex shape and concave shape. Amma, we are observing that we are having a convex shape and concave shape, so that the distance y is positive if it is measured from the central axis toward the convex side of the beam, and negative when it is measured toward the concave side of the beam or your curvature, whatever it is. Right. So I already told you that the positive stress means tensile stress, and a negative stress means compressive stress. Positive stress means tensile stress, and negative stress means compressive stress. Okay, right. So these are the sign conventions, and these sign conventions are very, very important, especially while you are deriving each standard cross sections. While you are go through the each and everything, you will observe this phenomenon. Right. So up to now, Amma, we try to determine the only bending stresses, and we try to determine the square value, standard value, that means the tensile stress and compressive stress, and we try to learn how to take conventions, whether it is a positive convention or negative sign conventions. And so I hope, Amma, this is very, very what we call dry things, because it is very difficult for me also reading out the equations rather than producing on the that means on the blackboard. So the difficult part for me also, for you, for listening also, it is a dry thing, because each and every step we are passing equations. So I know the difficulty of solving of equations, rather than it is better to solve rather than reading. I know the difficulty, but there is no other option as we are having. Please bear with us. At least only for this, you feel difficulty only for up to this derivation only. Amma, remaining things is very, very easy. Remaining things are very, very easy. And please pay an attention. Please pay an attention. At least you have to identify the equation. Identify the equation so that you can practice after having of the session. Then if you find any difficulty, then you came to your doubts. You please came up with your doubts on the next class, especially. Okay, right, fine. Thank you, Amma. Right, next. Now, this is very, very important part, Amma. This part is very, very important. You please pay an attention for this particular part, especially. Determination of factor of H square for various sections. And already from the above equation, you already observed this equation from your above steps, Amma. Y square and dA by 1 plus Y by R. And you will observe this kind of equations in case of your radius of curvature. I hope maybe you covered or not. I don't know, Amma. But especially in case of deflection of beams, deflection of beams, you find this terminology, deflection of beams. How many of you are aware of that deflection of beams? How many of you are aware of that deflection of beams? If you are not aware, there is no problem. Just for not to knowing whether you are aware it not, or just for asking, amma, whether you are aware of that radius of curvature, radius of curvature terminology, or deflection of beams. Because you came across this equation in case of your deflection of beams. Right. Anyway, if you are not came across, amma, no problem. No problem. Just simply remember the equation. That is sufficient. Remember the equation. We are not bothering about all those deflections. Only this equation is available, and the derivation of this equation is also available in your deflection of beams. That is why I am asking. That is the only thing. Right? Okay. Anyway. So y square into dA by 1 plus y by r integral of that equal to a into h square. Now simply try to determine the h square value. Try to determine the h square value, that is 1 by a of integral of y square by 1 plus y by r into dA. By using of your mathematical skills, what you have learned in your previous classes, you please solve those integral equation. You please try to solve those equation. And here y square by, here is saying that y square by r plus y is some of the difficult term. So that maybe he is neglecting higher order terms. I already know that. You please neglect in the higher order terms, so that you will get one final result. R cube by a into integral of 1 by r plus y into dA minus r square. Right. So this is the final equation of your SQL. You please remember this equation. You please remember this equation. This is very, very important equation. Very, very, very important equation. R cube by a integral of 1 by r plus y into dA minus r square. By substituting the values, here the y value plays a very, very important role. By substituting the values of y and dA for various sections, you please observe the statement, because as we are proceeding for standard section, same thing will apply on the particular equation. Again, we need not to derive all those things. Somewhat directly we'll apply this equation, h square equation. Directly we will apply this h square equation directly. H square equal to r cube by a integral of 1 by r plus y into dA minus r square. By substituting the values of y and dA from radius of curvature, from the radius of curvature, you please observe that from the radius of curvature, this y and dA values we can substitute. Y and dA value will get easily. How do you get the y values and dA values, amma? You please go back to your derivations of your moment of inertia, centroids, or shear stress values, right? Suppose if you are having a rectangular section, what you supposed to do? You consider a rectangular strip with the dA at a distance of y, central axis at a distance of y, and from your neutral axis the distance are d by 2, positive d by 2 and negative d by 2. So I hope you are recollecting. You please observe that same process will be applied here also, whatever the cross section it is. You please, you will follow the same procedure, right? You please try to recollect how we supposed to derive, or how you already derived the standard sections of your rectangle sections of your centroid or moment of inertia derivation part especially. So I'm having a small note. What is the moment of inertia of your rectangle section with respect to your base, rather than with respect to a central axis? What is the moment of inertia of a rectangular section? These are standard section, rectangle section, triangle, and circular sections. Standard sections. What is the moment of inertia? See, it is very, very unfortunate thing. Moment of inertia value. Or with respect to central axis, what is the moment of inertia with respect to central axis? Everybody can say xx at least. Again, I am specifying that xx. Maybe ak square means bd square by 2. maybe I am trying to assume the value AK square means. Rectangle section, central axis, about XX. But we just put circular section at least. Circular section. Moment of inertia for circular section. Moment of inertia for a circular section. Somebody is saying that BD cube by 12. Right, very good. For rectangle section, right? What about circular section? What about circular section? What about circular section? Anyway, okay, no problem. So pi d power 4 by 64. So my knowledge is see, because I'm normally I didn't remember the values, Amma, but fortunately those standard section values only I remembered. Fortunately, only the standard section values are remembered. Okay, anyway, so my knowledge is very very less because I didn't remember all those values. Just simply by making the derivation I remember. But by looking at the object, it is very difficult part for me also for remembering those values. So anyway, no problem. Right. Okay. So anyway, before we proceeding, so this is the how you supposed to start this. So you please remember S square value, Amma, please remember. Please remember this S square value, right? So while you were starting for your standard cross section, this square value plays a very very important role. All right. So now before you proceeding for your particular standard cross section, you please remember some basic points, Amma. Some basic point. What are those basic points? Means here, whatever the cross section it is. Whether it's a triangular section, rectangle section, triangle section, circular section, a trapezoid, or whatever it is. First, you try to determine the bending stress value. But according to your position of your neutral axis or based on your radius of curvature, it may be positive or it may be negative, as I said earlier, Amma, because you observe one equation. Why not by some r square plus y square or something like that, you observe an equation. So that based on the position, sign conventions may change, but the actual value will, equation will be same as easily, but you will get positives and negatives depending upon the position. And the second point is, Amma, you try to determine the value of h square. And again, in this case, we always bother about only a square value. No need to worry about the bending stress value because it is already derived in your previous step. So that the bending stress value will not be vary. Bending stress value is a standard value, right? But a square values will be varying from section to section, cross sections. Depending upon the cross section, those square values will be varying. So that only we will concentrate on h square value, right? And while you are starting off your equation, I already know that some basic assumptions are needed. We already discussed the assumptions also. Okay, right. Now we directly move on to the standard cross section. So if you observe one standard cross section thoroughly, then it is easy for the remaining sections. Okay, right. Fine. Okay. Now you please observe one of the important cross section, rectangle section, right? So this is the rectangle section. You please observe the figure. Again, I'm doing it right. I hope you are observing this figure clearly now, right? So this is a rectangle section as you're observing, with width B and depth D, right? and the center of curvature of the curved beam is 8.0. Please observe that radius of curvature with respect from your central axis and center of curvature at a 0.0. And the radius of curvature the radius of curvature is at a distance of r. The radius of curvature is at a distance of r from the centroidal axis. So these are the only terminologies we are having. Okay, ma. So I hope you are visible this particular figure on your screen, right? So that it is easy for you for each and every cross section. Once if you observe the one cross section, then it is easy for you for the remaining sections also, right? Now you please observe. I mean, you please try to analyze the terminology in the particular given figure. So B is the width and D is the depth. From the central axis, above the central axis, we can consider it is D by 2, and below it is D by 2, right? As you already know that the total distance is D. Now, so in order to analyze the value of h square for the total cross section, so as it is a symmetry section, so you can consider one elemental strip. One elemental strip. Those elemental strip, I mean, what we call, you are having B and thickness is dy, and a distance of y. The distance is at a distance of y. You are having an elemental strip at a distance of y. So these are the terminologies, right? So I hope you, if you observe this figure, Amma, already it is very much similar that of your centroid and moment of inertia, if you are observing carefully. But except radius of curvature we are having here, except radius of curvature, because it is a curved beam, so except radius of curvature, remaining things are very, very similar that of your centroid and moment of inertia. So please observe those things. Now same procedure. What you first initial step, what you supposed to do for a calculate the elemental strip area. What is the elemental strip area? Da equal to B into dy. Is this right, Amma? Already you already done so much of cross sections, or so many cross sections in your centroids and moment of inertia in this manner. First elemental strip da equal to B into dy. Now if we calculate total area, means total area B into d. Total area of cross section is B into D. If you want to calculate only elemental strip area, elemental strip area means DA equal to B into DY. Right? I hope these two equations are very clear. Right? I hope you are not having no doubt regarding of these two equations. Now you try to apply the equation of H square. I have told you that you not worry about the standard equation of bending stress. That is common for almost all sections. You have to worry about only h square values. Those h square values are depending upon your some da and y values. Already we discussed in the equation, in the previous equation we already discussed this point. Right, now write down the equation. H square equal to r cube by a integral of 1 by r plus y into da minus r square. Right, okay, fine. Now substitute each and every parameter. What are the parameters? What is the equation? H square equal to r cube by a. R cube is remain as it is because you require to determine the radius of curvature value. Now a value, a means area of the cross section, that is b into d. 1 by r plus y, right? 1 by r plus y remains as it is. Now area, da means b into dy. Da means b into dy. Now within the limits, what is the limit sum of plus d by 2 and minus d by 2? Above the neutral axis, your central axis having positive, below the central axis having negative values. So plus d by 2 and minus d by 2. Hope you understand this particular step, Amma, what I am explaining. Right? So this is the basic general integral procedure. Basic procedure. It is not that much difficulty. There is no any other equations or what we call product rule or division rule or all those things you are not having. Just simply you are applying the limits of d by 2 and minus d by 2. Right? Now you are supposed to integrate. Now you are supposed to integrate. Right? Now you are supposed to integrate. So here you are having, right, so r cube into so your common term b, please remove the term, I mean not remove the term, please take a side of b value outside integration and b into d plus d by 2 and minus d by 2 1 plus r by 1 by r plus y into dy minus r square. So simply do the calculation of your what we call integral approach, simple integral approach, right? So 1 by r plus y means logarithm, so logarithm or something like that. So already you know the basic formulas. What is my integral of 1 by x, 1 by x, integral of 1 by x or something like that. Yes, right. So just for your reference only I am saying that, amma. So integral of 1 by x, so based on this particular approach or particular concept we will get this kind of results, amma. So it is purely integral approach, purely integral approach. You please go ahead of your calculations and substitute your plus d by 2 and minus d by 2 values, plus d by 2 and minus d by 2 values. Okay, amma. So this is how you supposed to get, this is the only thing you supposed to do, right? So after that you will get the result, amma, simple result. So h square equal to r square into some 1 plus 1 by 3 d by 2 r square plus 1 by 5 d by 2 r power 4 plus so on by minus r square. And so r square equal to finally 1 by 3 d by 2 r square plus 1 by d by 2 r power 4 and so on. So this is, I mean this approach, this equation is continued equation, amma. So you can consider many, as many number of as terms, no problem. But what you supposed to do here is only just consider the value of y and da, that is the only thing. Remaining is integral approach, remaining thing is integral approach only. Here your calculation is regarding of about y and da. What is meant by y value and what is da value and what is a value? That is the only thing. And substitute in the given equation of h square value. As simple as that, amma. If you practice this equation, this is very 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 easiest equations. And also in the examination also they will ask to find out h square value of different cross sections for 7 marks question. For 7 marks question, they ask a question. They try to ask for derive the equation of h square value for various cross sections. Or they may ask for your first general equation of your bending stress and h square value. These are the only two possible questions. One is general equation of bending stress and h square value. Second question is based on your problems. Some problems means here based on your standard sections. On those standard section also simply you have to follow this approach only. This is the only approach you are having. There is no other approach or there is no other procedure. This is the only procedure that are available. Same thing, same procedure will be followed for your triangular section and circular section also. Just write down what is da and what is y value and what is a value and substitute in the relation. Suppose if you are having a triangular section, suppose again I am repeating, I mean in the Monday's class also again I am repeat the same thing for triangular section, but for your convenience only I am saying, for limit considerations only I am saying. See, this is for triangular section. So if you want to try, you can try, amma, for your by taking off your limits, amma, by taking off your limits. Okay. So you already over that point, amma, no problem. Pi d 4 by 64. Right. So you please observe that particular triangular section figure and try to find out the value of h square for this cross section. We can no need to worry because all the material is available with you. So practice yourself, and if you have any doubt, amma, definitely came up with your doubts. Again, I am repeating. Again, I try to repeat the same. Triangular section, circular section, and one problem based on your rectangle. One problem based on your rectangular section also, so that it is easy for you. So somebody is on your mic. You please put off your mic, amma. As it is overlapping, you please put off your mic. Okay. Anyway, so this is how you supposed to calculate in curved beams. Again, I am repeating that this is somewhat only mathematical calculations are involved. So that you practice based on the concept. Here I am explaining the only concept. I know that here I am explaining only the concept how you supposed to take the values with reference to figure only. But remaining thing is the mathematical part. You please proceed with your own mathematical knowledge as we are having the mathematical knowledge. So you please proceed with your mathematical skills, right? So the thing is here, the observation point is here. What kind of a concept are we are using? That is the basic point. And with respect to what point we are taking the values? What are the sign conventions? Right? All those things are only you have to observe here as a curved beams. And I already told you that if at all if you are finding difficulty, how you supposed to get those values in radius of curvature? You please go back to your strength of material textbook. If at all it is because already in your in our group, we published the list of textbooks also, and I already circulated the in your previous semester itself. I already circulated Alice Kurmi, and those were having Shanta materials. Please check in your group, Amma. We already posted some links of your textbooks, so that please download those textbooks and you please verify in Shanta materials, especially in deflection of beams. You are having a radius of curvature equation. How you get the radius of curvature equation? Only you have to observe on that particular equation. You need not to worry about the what are the deflection equation, all those things. We need not worry. I mean, you are not having all those things. Just for your knowledge only, what is my radius of curvature, right? And what is the equations we are applying? And how do you get the value of this y by 1 plus r by y square or something like that? You are having equation. Are you supposed to get those equation? All those things are available in this particular deflection of beam chapter in strength of materials. So I hope you are not covered in your earlier classes, particularly this this deflection of beam, so that you are not responded. I hope so. You please go back to your strength of materials textbook and verify this equation, especially this equation. And based on those equation, simply substitute the remaining relation. That is the only thing we are having. Substitution is important based on your mathematical skills of your what we called integral approaches. Mainly we are applying integral approach here. Integral approach, basic integral knowledge, not thorough knowledge. And basic integral knowledge is sufficient, right? So please follow the material what I provided. You please follow the material and please practice those things, Amma. And if you are having any doubt, please come up with your doubts, right? Please come up with your doubts, and we try to solve those doubts in our class, Amma. Right? Anyway, so this is a somewhat lengthy approach what we observed till now. Remaining two chapters also, somewhat dry equations are also available, but we can't do anything. You have to practice. We have to practice throughout this chapter. We are having same thing throughout this chapter, but the advantage side is standard cross sections only we are having questions. Only 4 or 5 standard cross sections we are having, 3 or 4 only, not 5 also, only 3 or 4 standard cross sections we are having. If you are thorough with the 3 or 4 cross sections, that is sufficient. Actually I don't know, ma'am, maybe we are having Andhra University examinations from next month, not this Monday. Next Monday, from 5th onwards, I hope 4th or 5th onwards, we're having Andhra University examinations in our college. So maybe. So definitely, we have to attempt. I mean, your classes will be how they are proceeded. All those things we don't know till now. If at all there is any update, Amma, we'll definitely post on your WhatsApp groups, and we may intimate you. Okay, please don't worry about when the college started, but be ready. But thing is, as already our HOD sir told that, you please be prepared. Please be ready whenever a call from college. Right. So anyway, so thank you, Amma. Thank you for patience, for reading, especially for reading out the equations. as it is very, very difficult for me and you also for listening, reading out all the equations. So anyway, thank you for your patience. Thank you very much.
Thank you.